Hello everyone, today's video is all about audio when you are streaming. Now, when most people get started in streaming and are looking at upgrading their setup, there's a couple of different things that people probably consider first. Some may consider upgrading their PC or their gaming system with a new, say, graphics card, CPU, so that their gameplay is much smoother and they can do things at higher settings with more frames. Perhaps they want to upgrade their camera. Maybe they've got a webcam and they want to upgrade to a more professional camera. Or perhaps they want to add some RGB lighting to the background or some accessories. But the most important thing to me is audio. Streaming is all about audio, in my opinion. So why do I think that stream audio is the most important thing when it comes to streaming? Well, if you look at any advice on YouTube, along Google, along different sites, you will see that they always talk about the streamer being the main draw of a channel. People don't go to different Twitch and YouTube streams for the gameplay necessarily, they're going for the person. And the key part in streaming about that is how you are interacting both with your teammates, for example, in games, but also, more importantly, with chat itself. If I can hear you talking to chat, that is a big draw for me already. I don't want you there just playing a game as if you would with your friends who would come around your house. I want you to be interacting with chat, having a conversation, maybe getting to know them, having a joke. And that's all done through your voice. You cannot type at the same time while playing. So audio is key. So if audio is key, how do you improve your audio so that it is clear and crisp as possible with any audio device, from a cheap £20 headset to the USB mic that I'm using now to something way more professional that costs thousands of pounds? Anyone can do these simple settings and it will help so much more than potentially even buying something to start with. Let's have a look and see what settings you need to change in OBS to help out. Okay, so we're taking a look at OBS. This is actually my stream setup with all different plugins for Twitch and everything. I've got my scenes down here in the bottom left, and I've got my audio here, my sources and everything. So let's take a look at the audio first, because this we can actually make quite a difference already. You can see here that I've got two different volume bars, one for my desktop audio and one for my mic. Now, as I mentioned before, the stream is all about you, not the gameplay. I don't want the gameplay to be overpowering my voice, so I have turned down the desktop audio. Now, this will be a personal preference. You would need to play around, maybe record yourself along with some gameplay and listen to it back and see if you can get the right volume here. I have personally left the mic at full volume. As I keep mentioning, the stream is all about you and I want people to hear my voice over everything. So I'd rather play with the desktop audio before I play with the mic. The only time I would play with the mic is if for some reason my voice was really loud. Maybe I'm very bad at speaking into the mic like this and shouting. So maybe I would turn it down there. But that's a really simple thing, just straight off the bat, that we can change. So the next thing we want to look at is background noise. And for this, OBS has a couple of filters that we can use to try and get rid of as much background noise as possible. So for this, you want to go to the mic input source here, and you want to click on the cog, and then you want to go to filters. Now, again, these are all set up for already, but we're going to go through each one of these, as all three of these are pretty key to helping make your sound more professional. We're going to start with the noise suppression. So to add this filter, you come to the plus down in the bottom left, and you've got a couple of different options here, and you just add noise suppression here. It'll ask you to customize a name, but since you only need one of these, probably okay with just leaving it as it is. From here, you've got only two options with this one. You've got a method. SpeedX used to be the OBS like default, but recently they've added RN noise as well. I would play around with those and see how your system handles with these. As it says, it affects CPU usage. the RN noise will use more CPU. So if you've got a lower system or you're playing CPU intensive games, maybe sticking with SpeedX will be fine. In my case, it is. And then you want to play around with this decibel level. Now, this suppresses any background noise, so maybe you've got some fans that are loud from your system. Maybe you've got like a fan in your room for like cooling you down, because some rooms get super hot, especially in summertime when you're locked away streaming. Anything like that, this suppression should be able to help deal with it. Okay, so now we've got suppression sorted out, the next one we're going to look at is the noise gate. Now again, this is similar to how we added the suppression. You click on the plus in the bottom left and you just click on noise gate. This time you get 5 different settings that you can change. The most important ones are these top two, the closed threshold and open threshold. So open threshold is when the noise gate gets activated. So anything below minus 22 will not be picked up, and then it closes once you're basically done. So basically what I'm trying to do here with the noise gate is I'm trying to get rid of keyboard sounds, mouse sounds. These are generally higher than what noise suppression would pick up, but you still don't really want these on stream. Again, these are going to be personal preferences. This is more of how your setup works. So again, you're gonna need to play around with these. These are my personal settings. Yours will probably be different. These ones are not so important. These I've left all as standard. But hopefully with these two filters, you should get rid of most background sound. Okay, so the final one we're gonna talk about is the compressor. As with the other two filters, you add these by clicking on the plus and you click on the top one here, which is compressor. And you will get these 6 options this time. The main important ones for us are going to be the top two, which are ratio and threshold. Now, what the compressor does is basically if you go over a certain level in sound, the compressor will reduce the amount of sound that comes out of it by the ratio that you have defined. So for example, if I go 10 decibels over the threshold, the compressor will ratio that down so I actually only go up 1 decibel. Now this is very good if you're like talking into the mic a lot, or like if there's a loud point, maybe you start shouting and screaming so that you don't burst your listeners' eardrums. It allows you to be a bit more expressive in your gameplay without ruining the watcher's experience. As with all the other settings, these just need to play around. I think for me, I actually left these pretty much as standard. I may have changed the threshold slightly. You should be pretty good with a ratio of 10 to 1, but if you're not happy, feel free to change. But with all these three filters set up, you should already notice a massive difference in your audio. As I say, this can be done with any mic. Doesn't matter if it is a very cheap £20 headset or a £1,000 mic. This can be done with any. This just increases it straight away. And there you have it. There is audio setup for 2020 in OBS. As always, if you like this video, drop it a like. If you liked all the rest of my videos on my channel, feel free to drop a sub and click the bell to know when I'm posting a video next. I do also stream on Twitch. Link is in the description below. I stream Monday, Wednesday and Thursday, 7 o'clock in the evening till 10 o'clock UK time. And then I also do a Saturday stream, 1 o'clock till 5 o'clock in the afternoon. If you want to catch me anywhere else, I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, and I'm on TikTok as well. Feel free to shoot me messages there. I also have a Discord, which I've recently given a spring cleaning. We're going now for a more stream advice, stream help kind of vibe, as well as my own stream channel as well. So feel free to drop in there and ask questions and talk to people, get to know them. Maybe make a connection with them, drop into streams, things like that. And until next time, see you later.